So here's an example of mistake proofing. Here's my car, and now if I put it in park, I can't actually move the lever. Unless I step on the brake, then I can put it in gear. And this is an example of mistake proofing. Keep people from doing things that are improper. Here's another example of mistake proofing. If you try and plug a electrical outlet in incorrectly because one side's wide and the other side's narrow, it just won't work. So it has to go in the way it's supposed to go in. And the same is true of a three-prong plug here. This thing's designed to only go in one way. And that's an example of mistake proofing, just to keep the idiots from doing it wrong. So here's another example of mistake proofing. Right? We have childproof caps where you literally have to pull this tab down and turn that to open it. Right? The idea here is it locks. You can't open it unless you do both things. And you actually can't do this one-handed either. So that might provide some limitations. But you get the idea. This is another way we mistake-proof prescription bottles to keep children out. So once we've narrowed our focus and figured out what we want to improve, where the problem is and what the root cause is, then the concept we want to employ is mistake proofing. So how would we come up with a countermeasure, a solution that would make it absolutely impossible for a human being to make this mistake? Remember, systems let people make mistakes. People do not make mistakes. Systems let people make mistakes. Atul Gawande worked with the World Health Organization. They came out with a surgical checklist, and it's six questions pre-op, six questions before incision, and about six questions before the patient is transported. And those things cut mortality rates in half, complication rates in half, reduce the number of times they had to go in to a patient again by 25%. So sometimes it's just simple things that can solve these problems. And so think about it in your own life. I mean, there's things like when you're in, you know, Microsoft Word or something and you decide to exit, it goes, are you sure you want to exit without saving your file? That's mistake proofing. All right? How you plug in a light switch? Mistake proofing. I mean, your automatic coffee pot that turns itself off is mistake proofing. All of these things have been implemented to keep people from making stupid mistakes. You know, leaving the iron on or something like that. And so when you're thinking about how to solve your problem, how to fix your root cause, you want to think about, is there a way to do that that might be simple? Now, just as simple as, you know, an electrical outlet where one prong is wider than the other prong, so you simply can't put it in the wrong way. That's simple. It should be inexpensive. Right? And again, on a two-prong light, making one end a little wider is not going to cost a fortune, right? And so what these things are going to do is make it easy for us to implement that, and cheap. You know, people go after the big expensive solutions, and that's not always the way to go about it. They should provide for immediate, and I do mean immediate, feedback or detection of a problem. So you should get feedback right away that you're trying to do it incorrectly. You know, I read one story about an automotive assembly plant where they had different brackets on either end of the drivetrain, so you simply could not install it backwards. It's just not possible, all right? So you should get immediate feedback, and it should allow for immediate corrective action. So we should be able to fix this immediately if it's a good solution. Now, the goal here is people can't make the mistake. If not, maybe it should detect the mistake and stop the line and cause things to straighten out. In Toyota, this is what they call automation. That's automation with the human touch. So it's smart enough to detect that it's had an error and stops the line and makes things happen. So that might be a type of mistake proofing. You know, in computer operations, batch jobs run and they come back with a return code. Well, a bad return code should trigger an action to stop the ongoing processing, all right? All of these things are fairly simple to implement. So that's mistake proofing. Find some examples in your life. Start looking for them, because those will give you clues and ideas about how you can mistake proof anything that you do. Be a money belt.